Let us begin.
With an Illuvion, Corypheus could cross into the Fade in the flesh.
Indeed. The Inquisitor can attest that these artifacts still work, if one knows how to use them.
What happens when Corypheus enters the Fade?
Why, he will gain his heart's desire and take the power of a god. Or, and this is more likely, the lunatic will unleash forces that tear the world apart.
In Redcliffe, I saw the future Corypheus built. We can't let that happen.
It was always so, was it not? The madman would bury us all.
Pardon me, but does this mean everything's lost unless we get to the Illuvion before him?
Corypheus has a head start, no matter how quickly our army moves.
We should gather our allies before we march.
Can we wait for them? We should send our spies ahead to the Arbor Wilds.
Without support from the soldiers, you'd lose half of them.
Then what should we do?
For starters, we don't let Corypheus worry us to death. Imagine how embarrassing that would be. Josephine, have our allies send scouts to meet us in the wilds. Leliana, your fastest agents will join them. Together, we'll have enough spies to slow down Corypheus's army until Cullen's soldiers arrive.
Such confidence. But the Arbor Wilds are not so kind to visitors. Old elven magic lingers in those woods.
We'd be remiss to not take advantage of your knowledge, Lady Morrigan. Please, lend us your expertise.
'Tis why I came here. Although it is good to see its value recognized.
Any further instructions, Inquisitor?
The Inquisition began as a handful of soldiers. Thanks to you, we're now a force that will topple a self-proclaimed god. I could ask for no finer counsel. No better guidance.
I speak for all of us when I answer. We could ask for no finer cause.
We'll hound Corypheus in the wilds before he can find the temple or this Illuvion.
Inquisitor.
How goes the battle, Captain?
The Red Templars fall beneath our blades, Your Worship. Commander Cullen says they're nearly finished. Our scouts saw Corypheus traveling towards an elven ruin to the north. We can clear you a path through his armies.
Do only what you must. We need enough people for a celebration when we get back to Skyhold.
We will not fail you, my lady, no matter what comes. Andraste guide you, Inquisitor.
I wonder, is it Andraste your soldiers invoke during battle, or does a more immediate name come to their lips?
Another way to let people down if I falter. Thank you for the reminder.
'Twas not I who raised an army of faithful to storm this land, Inquisitor. But I digress. If your scouts report accurately, I believe these ruins to be the temple of Mathal.
Which is?
A place of worship out of elven legend. If Corypheus seeks it, then the alluvion he covets lies within. Let us hope we reach this temple before the entire forest is reduced to ash.
Your faith in your commander is well placed, Ambassador. Victory is all but in sight. With our lays... Inquisitor, I hear this Illuvian lies in a temple nearby. That's where the fighting will be worst. Andraste keep you safe.
Move everyone immediately if the fighting comes closer.
You may count on it. Good luck.
We are gladdened to see you, Herald. This day will be recalled for ages. We are privileged to witness the fulfillment of the Inquisition's purpose.
The sight of our Orlesian allies risking their lives here humbles me.
Your worthy cause would have friends, even if we did not will it. Men and women of faith serve you. Their favor is no less than our own, their service no less dear. With Orlais at your side, we will see you victorious against Corypheus. May you walk in the light.
If the soldiers aren't careful with their fires, they'll do Corypheus's work for him.
Do you sense the magic crackling? Something more powerful than the Red Templars stirs.
As the sun renews itself, so must the faithful renew their love of the Maker. Your penance shall be a joy, serving him with a heart of love unbound. Your struggle shall be a gift, for it redeems you in his sight.
The Inquisition brought you this struggle. Without men like you, it would fall.
The fight is justly entered, Your Worship. I was a pilgrim at Haven. I saw the wreckage and how you emerged to lead us. If the Maker bids me serve you, it will be done.
Empress Selene's general is just down the hill, Inquisitor. He wishes to join you for the last.
Those were Grey Wardens. They must be the last of those enslaved at Adamant.
Poor bastards. Corypheus has them dying by the dozen.
Divine. The monsters are running, Your Worship.
There, ahead. An entire camp of Red Templars.
Look down. They've got archers on the wall.
Who were those elves? They didn't look Dalish.
It seems this Temple of Mithal is not deserted after all.
Perhaps these creatures are the reason few return from the Arbor Wilds.
Monsters, Inquisitor! The Freemasons stand with the light!
There. That must be the Temple of Mithal.
Be ready. Corypheus will be there.
Milana sub banale.
They still think to fight us, Master.
These are but remnants. They will not keep us from the Well of Sorrows.
Well of Sorrows?
Be honored. Witness death at the hands of a new god.
It cannot be.
Across the bridge, now.
At last, Mathal's sanctum. Let us proceed before Corypheus interferes.
I thought Corypheus was here for an alluvion. Why did he mention a well of sorrows back on the bridge?
I am uncertain of what he referred to.
Could they be the same? Could alluvion translate into well of sorrows?
No. It seems an alluvion is not the prize Corypheus seeks.
Yes, I was wrong. Does that please you? Whatever the Well of Sorrows might be, Corypheus seeks it, and thus you must keep it from his grasp.
Let's find this well before Corypheus's people do.
I want to know how Corypheus returned to life. We saw him die.
And his life force passes on to any blighted creature, Darkspawn, or Grey Warden.
Then Corypheus cannot die. Destroy his body and he will assume another.
We'll find a way to stop him once we're done here.
'Tis strange. Archdemons possess the same ability, and still the Grey Wardens are able to slay them. Yet Corypheus they locked away. Perhaps they knew he could do this. But not how. I see the Red Templars have already encountered the temple's guardians.
They hurt themselves for years to get stronger, but they still die so easily.
Perhaps we shall fare better. It appears the temple's magics are still strong.
Ancient Elven, I can't make out much.
Atishol vir Abalasan. It means enter the path of the Well of Sorrows.
There is something about knowledge, respectful or pure. Shivenen. Tis all I can translate. That it mentions the well is a good omen.
At least we know the Well of Sorrows was important.
Supplicants to Mathal would have first paid obeisance here. Following their path may aid entry.
So, good Andrastians, we offer a prayer to Elven gods.
If need be, unless you wish to turn back.
Hold them off!
Ah!
Come on, we might catch them.
Hold a moment. While they rush ahead, this leads to our true destination. We should walk the petitioner's path as before.
People are dying outside while we stand here. If we use the tunnel, more of our soldiers can flee.
In this case, I must agree with the witch. This is ancient ground, deserving of our respect.
You see the urgency. We cannot find the Well of Sorrows unprepared.
We don't know what's behind those doors. They might have a reason for going another way.
Had they the option, they would have proceeded. That must lead to their goal.
Their goal? Or yours?
There is a danger to the natural order. Legends walked Thedas once. Things of might and wonder. Their passing has left us all the lesser. Corypheus would squander the ancient power of the well. I would have it restored.
I wasn't expecting your answer to be so romantic.
Trust me, your surprise is matched only by my own. Mankind blunders through the world, crushing what it does not understand. Elves, dragons, magic. The list is endless. We must stem the tide or be left with nothing more than the mundane. This I know to be true. I read more in the first chamber than I revealed. It's said a great boon is given to those who use the Well of Sorrows, but at a terrible price.
What exactly did that altar say about the Well of Sorrows?
Like most elven writing, it was insufferably vague. The term I deciphered was Halam Shivanas, the sweet sacrifice of duty. It implies the loss of something personal for duty's sake, yet for those who served at this temple, a worthwhile trade.
Did you not trust me enough to tell me about this price when you read it?
I hoped to find more information. If I intended to cheat you, I would have feigned ignorance entirely. My priority is your cause, but if the opportunity arises to save this well, I am willing to pay the cost.
And gain what?
That is what we must discover. The rituals may point the way. Yes?
Are you certain Corypheus is using the power of the Blight to make himself immortal?
Perhaps you forget. I was in Ferelden during the Fifth Blight. I have seen a true archdemon rage. How Corypheus gained the power to send his soul into blighted bodies, that is the real question.
Will answering that question let us destroy Corypheus for good?
Perhaps. I would suggest first dealing with the well. If Corypheus obtains it, any chance of success could be lost.
I want to discuss the well again.
Oh, I see. An opportunity to use the well may not even arise. I understand this. All I meant to suggest is that if it does, I be the one to do so. I am willing to accept the consequences.
What if something happens to you? What about your son?
Kieran is a strong lad. He will thrive, with or without me.
Are you sure of that?
I am sure of precious little these days. Yes?
Do you know what this part of the temple was used for?
It may have served as a chamber of reflection, perhaps to contemplate the righteousness of one's cause. More importantly, I suspect none were permitted beyond this area without a priest. Ancient texts claim Mithal passed judgment in the flesh, but 'twas surely the priests who proclaimed rulings here.
Why did the ancient elves insist on so many rites?
we may safely assume one did not petition High Priests for Mathal's justice by strolling up and knocking. I see no more insufferable ceremony here than in a chantry.
You said this Mathal was worshipped as a goddess.
So one assumes. What is a god but a being of immense power? The dread old gods were nothing more than dragons, after all. They rise as archdemons, and they die. Perhaps Mathal was a powerful elf, a ruler among her kind. History often plays storyteller with facts.
You admit lack of knowledge, and yet dismiss her so readily?
I do not dismiss her. I question her supposed divinity. One need not be a god to have value. Truthfully, I'm uncertain Mathal was even a single entity. The accounts are varied.
There are varied accounts of Mathal.
In most stories, Mathal rights wrongs while exercising motherly kindness. Let fly your voice to Mathal, deliverer of justice, protector of sun and earth alike. Other paint her as dark, vengeful. Pray to Mathal and she would smite your enemies, leaving them in agony.
More Dalish tales, I assume.
If you know more about this, Solas, speak.
The oldest accounts say Mathal was both of these, and neither. She was the mother, protective and fierce. That is all I will say. This is not a place to stir up old stories.
Whatever the truth, all accounts of Mathal end the same. Exiled to the beyond with her brethren.
What do you mean, exiled?
Tricked by the Dread Wolf, as all the Elven gods were said to be, trapped in a land beyond the Fade. Many Dalish believe this is why the Elves fell from grace, and their gods did not save them. Or perhaps they were simply rulers slain by Tevinter. Who can say?
You've seen the Elves here. They seem odd.
Indeed. Two things are possible. One, this is a group of Dalish separated from their brethren, cultists, fanatic in their desire to keep humans away. Two, these are elves descended from the ancients, having resided here since before the fall of Arlathan. The second appears unlikely, but if true, the implications are astounding.
If they keep records, it could change everything we thought we knew about history.
'Tis thrilling, no? To discover an era thought lost forever has possibly thrived in the shadows. We may, however, find these elves reluctant to part with their long-kept secrets.
More rituals. What are they for, do you know?
I believe they signify an intent to lay oneself bare, to champion a cause without pity, regret, or shame. Mathal's cult was not fond of vacillation. One approached them with nothing less than complete confidence.
What happened to those who were less sure of themselves?
Legend does not say. Perhaps this place has a more gruesome history than we know.
Let's continue.
As you wish. Time to proceed to the next ritual, I should think.
Oh.
The ritual is complete.
We are close. There is but one more path to follow.
Everything is lit.
The whispers are louder.
Come, let us see if the doors have opened. Tis not what I expected. What was this chamber used for?
We're being watched.
Venavis. You are unlike the other invaders. You have the features of those who call themselves Elven. You bear the mark of magic, which is familiar. How has this come to pass? What is your connection to those who first disturbed our slumber?
They are my enemies, as well as yours.
I am called Abelas. We are sentinels, tasked with standing against those who trespass on sacred ground. We wake only to fight, to preserve this place. Our numbers diminish with each invasion. I know what you seek. Like all who have come before you, you wish to drink from the Vira Belasan.
The place of the Way of Sorrows. He speaks of the well.
It is not for you. It is not for any of you.
Solas, perhaps he'll listen to you.
What shall I say, Inquisitor? Shall I sway him from a millennia of service by virtue of our shared blood? He clings to all that remains of his world, because he lacks the power to restore it.
Our people have lost everything. They need you. They could learn from you.
Our people? The ones we see in the forest, shadows wearing Valisleen. You are not my people. And you have invaded our sanctum as readily as the Shemlin.
We knew this place was sacred. We've respected it as best we could.
I believe you. Trespassers you are, but you have followed rites of petition. You have shown respect to Mithal. If these others are enemies of yours, we will aid you in destroying them. When this is done, you shall be permitted to depart. and never return.
This is our goal, is it not? There is no reason to fight these sentinels.
Consider carefully. You must stop Corypheus, yes, but you may also need the well for your own.
I accept your offer.
You will be guided to those you seek. As for the Vera Bellasan, it shall not be despoiled, even if I must destroy it myself.
No!
Morrigan! This would be our guide.
Mytholan asked.
That's helpful, since Morrigan chased off on her own.
She seeks to protect the Well of Sorrows.
She turned into a bird.
This place looks untouched.
I've seen Elysian palaces with less gold. What did the ancient elves do here?
Perhaps it was meant to kindle a sense of awe in visitors.
Well, it's working.
Kenshra, Gilas Velathan.
I believe she would prefer that we remain close.
Just a quick look around.
Vir Sumil.
The Well of Sorrows.
Maker's balls.
So Mythal endures.
It's loud and so cold.
You tough bastard. A day's march, hours of fighting, and still fierce as dragons. The Chantry never knew what it was throwing away.
Samson! Sir, watch out!
Inquisitor, you and those elf things don't know when to stop. You've hunted us half across Thedas. I should have guessed you'd follow us into this hole.
I spoke with your Tranquil, Maddox. He sacrificed himself for your cause.
I told him not to. He died as one of us then, one of the faithful. Corypheus chose me twice. First as his general, now as the vessel for the Well of Sorrows. You know what's inside the well? Wisdom. The kind of wisdom that can scour a world. I give it to Corypheus, that he can walk into the Fade without your precious anchor.
What's your part in it? What's a vessel?
What else empties a well? I'll carry its power to Corypheus. One more task entrusted to me. Being force-fed Chantry Lyrium was good for something. This armor makes me a living fortress, mind and body. I won't forget a word of the well's knowledge. Corypheus will be unstoppable.
Once Corypheus is that powerful, you and your soldiers will just slow him down.
You dare say that to my face? After you butchered my men? You're no match for Corypheus. Even if you drink from the well, you'll never master its wisdom as he could. This
is the strength the Chartry tried to bind. But it's a new world now, with a new god. So, Inquisitor, how will this go?
Power's all well and good, until it's taken away.
What did you do? What did you do? My armor. It's gone. The lyrium. I need it! Kill them all! Take it from Corypheus. You mustn't.
Still breathing after all that. Impressive.
We can take him back to Skyhold for judgment.
You heard his parting words, Inquisitor. The elf seeks to destroy the Well of Sorrows.
So the Sanctum is despoiled at last.
You would have destroyed the well yourself, given the chance.
To keep it from your grasping fingers. Better it be lost than bestowed upon the undeserving.
Fool. You'd let your people's legacy rot in the shadows.
Samson thought the well's knowledge was valuable. It could help stop Corypheus.
I care nothing for your petty conflicts, Shemlin.
You'll care when Corypheus arrives for the well.
The well clearly offers power, Inquisitor. If that power can be turned against Corypheus, can you afford not to use it?
Do you even know what you ask? As each servant of Mithal reached the end of their years, they would pass their knowledge on through this. All that we were, all that we knew, it would be lost forever.
It's better that knowledge remain in the well, never passed on. You'd rather destroy it.
There are other places, friend, other duties. Your people yet linger.
Elven such as you?
Yes, such as I.
You have shown respect to Mithal, and there is a righteousness in you I cannot deny. Is that your desire? To partake of the Vera Belisan as best you can? To fight your enemy?
Gifts like this don't come freely.
No boon of Mithal was ever granted without cost. The Vera Belisan may be too much for a mortal to comprehend. Brave it if you must. But know you this. You shall be bound forever to the will of Mithal.
Bound to a goddess who no longer exists, if she ever did?
Bound as we are bound. The choice is yours.
Is it possible this Mithal might still exist?
Anything is possible.
Elven legend states that Mithal was tricked by Fenharel and banished to the beyond.
Elven legend is wrong. The Dread Wolf had nothing to do with her murder.
Murder? I said nothing of...
She was slain, if a god truly can be. Betrayed by those who destroyed this temple. Yet the Vera Balasan remains. As do we. That is something.
Are you leaving the temple?
Our duty ends. Why remain?
There is a place for you, Letheline. If you seek it.
Perhaps there are places the Shamlin have not touched. It may be that only Uthenra awaits us. The blissful sleep of eternity never to awaken. If fate is kind.
Thank you for this gift, Abelas.
Do not thank me yet, Shemlin.
Malas Amali Nahalam Abelas. His name, Abelas, means sorrow. I said, I hoped he finds a new name.
You'll note the intact Illuvian. I was correct on that count, at least.
Is it still a threat? Can Corypheus use it to travel the Fade?
You recall when I took you through my Illuvian, I said each required a key? The well is the key. Take its power, and Mathal's last Illuvian will be no more use to Corypheus than glass. I did not expect the well to feel so hungry.
Seems like that should be a concern.
Knowledge begets a hunger for more. I am willing to pay the price the well demands. I am also the best suited to use its knowledge in your service.
Or more likely to your own ends?
What would you know of my ends, elf?
You are a glutton drooling at the sight of a feast. You cannot be trusted.
Of those present, I alone have the training to make use of this. Let me drink, Inquisitor.
You alone? This is my heritage.
I have studied the oldest lore. I have delved into mysteries of which you could only dream. Can you honestly tell me there is anyone better suited?
What about you, Solas?
No. Do not ask me again.
Perhaps you're right.
I am. You know I am.
You're not concerned about the price. Bound forever to the will of Mithal.
Bound to the will of a dead god? It seems an empty warning. Perhaps a compulsion yet remains. Who can say otherwise? I do not fear it, even so.
Are you sure you want this, Morrigan? We don't know what will happen.
We do not, and yet it must be done. I am ready.
Thoughts?
She is right about only one thing. We should take the power which lies in that well.
I trust you with this power more than her. But it's not for me to decide.
So many voices. They would be in your head, talking over you. You don't want them.
Enough deliberation. Give me your decision.
It's yours. Morrigan! Are you all right?
Elasin Salah. Visan Allah. I am intact. There is much to sift through, But now we can... It is done.
I'm pleased to report we won the battle, Inquisitor. When you went through that mirror, Corypheus and his arch-demon fled the field. I'm not sure why.
What he wanted was no longer within the temple.
Perhaps. He spent so long trying to get into the temple, he probably couldn't have helped his forces by that point.
Then Corypheus is finished.
If he is wise, he will hide and rebuild his strength before he attacks again.
He will not hide.
Meaning he will attack us directly, at Skyhold.
Not necessarily, but neither will he remain idle.
And how could you have such insight into his plans?
The Well of Sorrows held many voices, and they speak to me now from across the ages. They hold wisdom, secrets I never dreamed possible. But even they fear what Corypheus has become.
Should we fear him more than his army?
Possibly. Luckily for you, he has a weakness. The dragon he calls is not truly an archdemon. It is a dragon in which Corypheus has infested part of his being. He doubtless did so out of pride to emulate the gods of old. That pride can be exploited. Kill the dragon, and his ability to leap into other bodies is disrupted. He can be slain.
You're sure? If there are no bodies for him to jump to?
You assume there is a limit to the range of his power. There is not.
Then what do you propose? Killing the dragon is no simple task, if it could even be found.
There is a way to defeat the dragon, to match Corypheus in his power. The well whispers it to me now. Your help will be required, Inquisitor. Speak to me when you are ready, and we shall begin.
I'll see to Skyhold's defenses in the meantime.
It comes swiftly, this moment that would be spoken of for ages. The day the Herald of Andraste challenged the Darkspawn, that thought itself a god. Defeat him, and you'll be more than a holy woman to the people. You'll enter legend.
I couldn't have come this far without the Inquisition at my back.
And there is the modesty people respect. People joined the Inquisition after hearing you were blessed, but they've stayed because of how you lead. I wanted to tell you that I shared their sentiments, Inquisitor, and... well, I suppose I just did.
You've always been there for us, Josephine. And for me.
It means much to hear you say that. Farewell, my lady. When you face Corypheus, may you walk in the light.
So, I'm still trying to wrap my mind around this. We went to an elven rune, so a witch could consume a pool of magical goo and then walk through a mirror. And wound up back here. Have I mentioned that the shit that happens to you is crazy? I don't want to think about this anymore. You want to discuss something normal?
Can I ask you something, Varric?
You want to talk about me? I'm flattered. Also inclined toward extravagant lies.
Thanks, Varric.
No problem.
The Temple of Mathal was extraordinary. In all my journeys, I never dreamed of finding anything like it. What will you do with the power of the well once Corypheus is dead?
I'll use whatever power I have to undo the chaos that Corypheus and his allies have caused.
You would put things back the way they were before?
Yes. I mean, not exactly.
I know what you mean. Thank you.
For what?
You have not been what I expected, Inquisitor. You have impressed me. You honor the past and work to recover what was lost, even if the cost is high. I respect that. And I am indebted to you for the reminder. Forgive my melancholy. Corypheus has cost us much. The Temple of Mathal did not deserve such a fate. The orb he carries, and its stolen power, that at least we may still recover. With luck, some of the past may yet survive.
You're being grim and fatalistic in the hope of getting me into bed, aren't you?
I am grim and fatalistic. Getting you into bed is just an enjoyable side benefit. Come with me, Venan. The veil is thin here. Can you feel it on your skin, tingling? I was trying to determine some way to show you what you mean to me.
I'm listening, and I can offer a few suggestions.
I shall bear that in mind. For now, the best gift I can offer is the truth. You are unique. In all Thedas, I never expected to find someone who could draw my attention from the Fade. You have become important to me. More important than I could have imagined.
As you are to me.
Then what I must tell you, the truth. Your face, the Valislean. In my journeys in the Fade, I have seen things. I have discovered what those marks mean.
They honor the elven gods?
No, they are slave markings. Or at least they were in the time of ancient Alathan.
My clan's keeper said they honored the gods. These are their symbols.
Yes, that's right. A noble would mark his slaves to honor the god he worshipped. After Alathan fell, the Dalish forgot.
So this is... what? Just one more thing the Dalish got wrong?
I'm sorry.
We try to preserve our culture. And this is what we keep? Relics of a time when we were no better than Tevinter.
Don't say that. For all they got wrong, the Dalish did one thing right. They made you. I didn't tell you this to hurt you. If you like, I know a spell. I can remove the Valislean.
If what you're saying is true...
It is.
Then... my people vowed never to submit to slavery.
I'm so sorry for causing you pain. It was selfish of me. I look at you and I see what you truly are. And you deserve better than what those cruel marks represent.
Then cast your spell. Take the Valislean away.
Sit.
Palasa Malarevas. You are free. You are so beautiful. And I am sorry. I distracted you from your duty. It will never happen again.
Solas.
Please, Venan.
Tell me you don't care.
I can't do that.
Tell me I was some casual dalliance so I can call you a cold-hearted son of a bitch and move on.
I'm sorry.